Hey everybody, and welcome back to Google Plus Developers Live. I'm Joanna Smith, and I'm a developer programs engineer for Google Plus, and today I'm being joined by two product managers, Thor and Joelle, to talk about the new Google Plus Domains API. We launched this at I.O., we announced it anyway, this summer, and we're really excited because now it's finally publicly available. So Joelle, why don't you tell us a little bit about why we built this?
Thanks, Joanna. I'm Joelle Kalmanowicz. I'm a product manager on Google Apps, and I focus on Google Plus. Now, the intersection of Google Apps and Google Plus is enterprise social networking, and we're really excited in this space because we can do things with Google Plus that we can't really do out in the consumer public world, because enterprises, being businesses and schools, use a lot of third-party tools for other purposes in the day-to-day life of a professional. So this means we can integrate Google Plus as a social spine across other services and not just have to build things onto Google Plus itself.
Well, thanks for joining us, Joelle. Thor, can you give us some insight into some of the new features that are special for the Google Plus Domains API?
Sure. So hi, my name is Thor Mitchell. I'm a product manager for the Google Plus API. When we started working with the enterprise team on this API, it became clear there are a couple of areas that we should focus on. The first is circle management, so creating circles and syncing circles to, for example, a corporate directory, managing the people in circles. The second was the stream. So both understanding the way that users within a domain are using the stream and what they're posting, what they're sharing and commenting on, and also allowing third-party applications to post to the stream.
Thanks, Thor. So I know we just teased you with some really cool features that you want to get to know how to use, so let's go ahead and take a look at how you can do this. And the first step, as always, is to go to developers.google.com/plus/domains, and this is going to be your gateway into learning what's up. And we tried to do what we could like really do to help you out. So we organized the entire left navigation bar by feature and by what you might want to do. So, you know, straight up, let's get started. And what we did here is we created a chart that I think is really fantastic because it compares the existing Google Plus API to the Google Plus Domains API. And this means that if you've already been developing for Google Plus, you can see what's new and what's different that you might want to start exploring right away. And then, of course, we have two quick starts, Java and Python. And the best thing about these is they show off a different type of authentication. Because everybody kind of has started to get a grasp now of server-side OAuth authentication, where you can actually authenticate on a user-by-user basis. And we have the code here for you to show you how to do that. But what's cool is we also now have domain-wide delegation. And what this means is instead of authenticating one user at a time, you can actually authenticate an app on behalf of all of the users within a domain at once.
It's important to note that this functionality is only available to the domain admins, and it's exactly the same as it works with other Google Apps APIs, such as the Drive API. So this allows Google Apps admins to be able to say, yes, it's okay for this app to authorize to act on behalf of anyone in the domain, because they're essentially installing a product for their entire systems across their business or school.
Definitely, that's exactly right. And because this is so different from what we've historically offered for the Google Plus platform, we decided to make this the main authentication we use in our quick start. So if you'd like to see it running, you can go ahead and download that from our GitHub repo and get started. And then what we have is we have different things that you might want to do, different API calls you might want to make. They're classic getting profiles with your people.git. We also have managing circles. And what we have here are multiple ways for you to actually make sure your circles are all constantly up to date. And Thor mentioned this briefly earlier, but you can create circles, you can delete circles, you can add people, remove people, see the people that are in a circle, see the circles that a person has. There are so many different things you can do to help make sure that your circle management is as easy as it should be. Then we have the ability for you to read posts. And what's really cool about this is that it's no longer limited to just the posts that have been publicly shared. And so we've got the code here for you to do it. But Thor, do you want to take a moment to explain like what's different about the domain sharing?
Sure. So when you're using the existing public Google Plus API that we've had for a while now, you can authenticate as yourself. But then the API only offers access to content that you've shared publicly. In the Google Plus Domains API, as a user in an apps domain, the API can access any of the content that you've shared with any audience. However, when you post using the API, you can only create a restricted post, which is a post that cannot leave that domain.
Exactly. So let's go ahead and take a look at how to create a post. And it's pretty straightforward. All you have to do is create the message that you want to say, create the body, and that's going to be the content. And what we have here in this Python is we have the post being created through an activities.insert call, and it's done as a JSON object. And so you see, we send the original content, which is just, you know, your message that you want to say. And then what we do is we set the sharing. And right here, this one's being shared with the domain. And then, of course, we set the domain restricted parameter to true. This has to be the case on every single call you make to activities.insert, or else it's going to fail, because you cannot post beyond your domain. And then also on this page, we have how to share to a specific circle, how to share to a person, how to write a comment. But even cooler, you'll see on the left nav, we show you how to attach URLs, how to attach media if you want to attach a photo or a video, and also how to do a reshare programmatically. So there's a lot for you to discover here at developers.google.com/plus/domains. But let's go ahead and take a step back and look at the bigger picture. We talked about some of the really cool features in the new API calls, but maybe we should discuss some of the use cases for them.
So as I said before, one of the main motivations we had for developing this is because in the enterprise space, for businesses and schools, usually your users and your admins are already making use of a lot of third-party tools. They can be things like provisioning, they can be customer reference management, you can be all sorts of things. I mean, for schools especially, you can have learning management systems, excuse me. So this means that actually one of the really cool things for me is in this API, we allow circles management. So this means that working with Ocado, we've actually developed a little cool script that lets you pull data from something like a file or Active Directory or LDAP, and you can actually look at this hierarchical data and turn it into circles. So a new user can join a company and start off with teammates, managers, executives, you know, people that you should be following, or your local chefs because everyone loves them, especially here at Google. Or even in the school, you can start and you can have your classmate circle ready to go.
As far as stream integration is concerned, there are a couple of clear use cases there as well. One is you might have an existing CRM system or content management system or some other software that you license from a third-party enterprise software vendor, and they might add functionality to their tool that allows that tool to publish to the stream on your behalf. So for example, once you meet a sales target or to share your calendar for the day on Google Plus or something like that. Another example is reporting and auditing. We have an example, CloudLock, that we mentioned in the launch blog post, which creates tools for helping you understand how your employees are using Google Plus and other services.
So I think that there might be some confusion regarding who can develop for Google Plus and for the Domains API specifically. Joel, do you want to clarify that?
Sure. Anyone can develop. The only thing is, in order to actually test using real API calls and to authenticate, you have to be logged into a real Google Apps domain account. So if you try and make an account which is not a Google Apps domains account, that means things, as you might be familiar with, Premier or Standard, then you won't be able to make these API calls successfully.
All right. Well, thanks so much for joining us, you guys. And I want to thank all of you for joining in and tuning in, because this is a really exciting new API, totally brand new. We announced it, like I said, at I.O., but now it's finally public, and I encourage you to get started. And once again, if you want to learn what all we have to offer, you can go to developers.google.com/plus/domains. Or if you want to just see some code running already, you can go to github.com/Google+ and look for the G+-domains repos, because those are the ones that are going to have the domains quick starts. And then, of course, you can always ask your questions.
Yeah, so I encourage you to join our Google Plus community called Developing with Google Plus if you want to discuss this API with like-minded developers. We also have a public issue tracker. Just search for Google Maps. Sorry, wrong product. Google Plus issue tracker. And that's where you can go to request new features or report any problems you might find.
And for any technical questions, you can always submit them at Stack Overflow. Please be sure to use the tag Google-Plus.
Exactly. So once again, thanks you guys, and thank you to our product managers for joining us today. And right before we sign off, I have one announcement, which is that please don't freak out if you don't see a Google Plus Developers Live episode next week or the week after. We are planning something really big in our brand new series of episodes, but we need some time to finalize that and really make sure that we're doing a great job. So we ask for your patience as we take a brief hiatus from Google Plus Developers Live. And on that note, have a great week.